I first met Eric Johnson, B.B. King's, this was about 5 or 6 years ago, and I said, man, we should do something together. And he said, yeah, let's do it. And then we made a little tour around it. And it went so well, we decided to record and do some of my tunes, some of Eric's tunes, and some stuff that, and really keep it loose and eclectic.
This record that Mike and I've done is kind of a mix of old and new. You know, we kind of just looked at some of the old music that that Mike or I or both of us felt that we were interpreting in a really profound way to where it warranted redoing it.
Guitarists tend to be kind of open-minded in that regard because they hear their instruments so many different kinds of music. So we started recording, and it's been a beautiful experience, really happening. I think it's coming out great. The bringing together of our styles is a natural hookup. Eric, I can tell you, is a very sensitive player, so he can work with a whole bunch of different people, and I think that's what I concentrate on myself too, to try to get. What, no matter what kind of vibe it is or who I'm playing with, try to get the right feeling.
Well, we're here to make music. You know what I mean? There's no other agenda. I feel like, you know, Mike does stuff that Eric can't do and vice versa. And so it's two very unique guitarists that are not in competition with each other in any way. It's just sort of a mutual admiration society almost.
I mean, it's definitely two very different styles. I mean, you have this jazz thing and this rock thing coming together. It's not your average jazz record, it's not your average rock record, you know, so it's got a lot going on.
Sections, you know, the comping behind our solos is really just super chilled out. And then when one of us is playing the melody, you know, the other's playing just, you know, sparse chords. It's not like, it's not a thing where you want to jump in and try to, you know, get as much in as you can get.
You know, one thing I like about this recording that we're doing is we're leaving a lot of live stuff. We want the live vibe. We don't want to do like, okay, let's get the rhythm section first and get the snares sounding so pristine, and there's nothing like that. You cannot get that if you overdub too much. You might get a better tone here and there, but if you let your heart go and that you seize the moment, it's like it's you can't get it any other way, and that's kind of what we're looking for.